I've started off with putting some texture paste onto my paper. I'm using a mixture of sand texture paste and smooth. So I've put this on. I've left a sort of gap in the middle where my detail is going to be, and I've put more of my texture paste around the edge, and I need to let that dry, so I'm going to go and grab a coffee before I start. So my texture medium is dried off. I didn't have any brekkie, so I'm all good and ready to go. I'm working on an image which I will pop into the video here, and this is a couple of images I took when I was at Willie Lotts Cottage, which is where Constable painted the Haywain. And it's a beautiful spot. I'm not going to try and recreate the Haywain, but I want to do my version of this location. I'm working in acrylic, and I'm just going to start by very basically blocking in. So we need a little bit of sky. I'm not trying to do this wholly representationally though. There's water down here too, so I'm just whacking this colour down. I'm using my favourite brush, which is this 30mm flat brush. Then I'm going to come in with a water spray. It's just plain tap water. I am also going to grab a roller. Gives you that texture of water. It's just, again, stopping it being predictable. That's what I'm trying to do here. So each time I do this, I just give it a wipe so it doesn't get messed up. And there's places where I don't have enough colour. And there's places where I'm going to do another layer. In fact, I'll probably end up doing another layer over the whole lot. So, having put this in, let's just add a little bit of something else whilst I'm here. I'm going to dry it off in a minute. So this is about, for me, about working out where things are going to be. Going in with my water spray. Take the puddles away. And then I think I need to dry this layer and then come back in again. Okay, so we are going to put another layer on. It's pretty much the same as the first layer. I just want to create some more of these kind of little patches, so just need more of the above. I've got some ultramarine white. Ultramarine blue, some white, and a little bit of a phthalo. And that gives me this. I've not mixed it well, as you can see. Keep my cover over all of that bit, so let's clear some of that. It's very pale up here. by doing it as two layers, I'm going to spray some water on in a minute and you'll get different effects, so it's quite interesting. There's sort of white paper showing through, I'm getting those underneath colours coming through. Got a little more ultramarine. English scene, so I'm using more of the ultramarine than I am the phthalo, because that's quite a tropical colour and I don't really want this to be tropical. I think I will add some clouds into this in a minute, just whilst I've got this colour here. Thickening up some of the colour down there. I've got lots more to do down there. I'm taking my white. I'm just going to see where my clouds are going to go in amongst these other bits, and it's kind of telling me that they go in across here. Using a round brush just to roll some of this paint around. Again, when this layer's dry, I'll come back in and add to it. Love this little bit here. Not sure about this shape, that's a bit inorganic, isn't it? Making a slightly richer blue, just in parts. I'm just using my smaller brush now, just to include that in areas I want. See the places where there's gaps in the painting. If I want to change the shape of something, this is a bit, still not keen on that shape, that's better. Down here, don't want too much detail because I'm going to put the cottage in here, so I don't want to take away from that with too complicated a sky behind it. A lot of this will cover over, but just to make sure there is some paint there for now. That's particularly nice. Of places, but not all. I need a bit more drying, so let me just do that bit. Okay, so I'm going to have one more play up here now that's dried off. I'm coming back in with my round brush. There's just a few places where it feels like it's a little bit light, a little bit thin. So, same colours, the two blues. So I've got these two. This is the ultramarine, this is my phthalo and my white. And I'm just mixing here. Doesn't have to be perfect all over, but I just wanted to make sure it looked like I'd painted it all. Quite like how that piece has got the sort of speckled effect. And I'm going to come in with some more white at the tops of my clouds. I'm also just going to use a damp finger just to smudge a little bit. Not doing loads. Just trying to add a bit more layering to it. Don't know what that triangle is, but I don't like it. Just taking a wet finger just to punch out any hard marks. I don't want to lose all of those strips, but I don't want them all the way down, so I'm crossing over them a little bit. Quite scrubby, quite rough. This isn't a perfectly finished painting, that's not what I'm trying for here. Okay, so what I need to do next, I need to leave this. I might come back and add or detract from that, but I need to kind of get this swathe across here. The base of the trees, not the big ones that come up, just the sort of the base area. So this is quite dark, not quite sure how and what I want to do on that. I'm going to use this brush, which is a 18 flat, so it's a medium sized flat brush, and it's about mixing some darks really. So I've got some burnt sienna and some umber. It was autumn when we were here. just come forward slightly here so it drops down on either side really. So I'm starting with this, but I just need to build more paint. Little bit of green is showing through, and it's going to show through even more when I do a bit of this. Especially at the bottom. Now I'm going to add some ultramarine into my umber, start making it darker. So I've got the burnt sienna, the umber and the ultramarine all in together, creating this. Over those runs just to make that more reflective. Clean off my roller. Now at the moment, my house here is way too central. I want my house to be more over this side. Let's take a little bit of that out. And bring some of this in there. I think I need to have another dry. Okay, so I've let that bit dry back, and what I've actually done is I have, excuse me, I'm scrummaging around getting bits and pieces. What I've done here is I've actually drawn the house in pencil because I needed it to be accurate. I want all of this to be really loose and rough, but I want this to be recognisable. So I wanted to draw that in with a little bit more detail. But I'm still going to paint it loosely to start off with. I'm going to block it in. So I've got some white here. It's a white building. It's going to have some shadows on it. But to start with, I just need to remove the background. as I do this, I'm just going to drop bits of those reflections in. This is just my first layer. And at the end here we have this end panel of the house comes around this chimney. Again, that's a bit longer. I don't mind going over the chimney. I can paint the chimney back over the white much easier than anything else. Some brick colour, so I'm going to use my burnt sienna and some yellow ochre . Tiny touch of white, that's too much white. So we've got the tiles, they're all clay pan tiles, presumably made with a local clay. It's going to be finished off, but just make sure I put that return in. And down there. Just a little bit of brown in there because this roof behind here is slightly darker and we can emphasize that more later. That just sits it in behind. Lock in the chimney and there is another chimney here and this one comes down and is visible at the side of the house, so all of that needs to come into a reflection. take a blue brown mix just to block in my windows. So we've got a bit of a window there, and it's got a bit of a reflection there. To make it darker behind the edges there. And a little here as well. Okay, so we're blocked in, need to let that dry. It's ended up a bit central, would have preferred it to be about there. It's no good, got to do something about it. Value of drying your layers. Okay, so I've moved the house across a little bit, so I need to paint it back in again and then repair a little bit of stuff here. So I'm doing exactly the same, just blocking in to start with, and that was the whole point of the blocking in, was to see whether I liked where it was. Putting this loosely in your composition. You can move things. I haven't done any drawing before I started, so let's have a look at that composition and see if I like it better, but I suspect I will. Okay, now that I've got my composition sorted, I'm going to come back up into the sky a little bit and work back into that. I don't really want to do the edges, I just want to focus on this bit in the middle. And what it looks like to me is I just need a bit more of that brighter blue in there. just a touch. See, I've got it more in the background. Could even take more. I need to work a little more into this area here. So I think I'm going to stick with my round brush. Now, looking at these properties, there's quite a lot goes on up here and it's quite dark, so I need to build that layer. This is going to be, this area needs to be, there's a little wall at the bottom there, but that is really quite dark behind there, and if that's quite dark then that's quite dark too. Comes up, it obviously gets a bit more light into it, so I don't want to make it too dark all the way up. And I also want to echo whatever colours I use over there, I want to echo over here. As we go off down here, there's other things happen down there, so I want to grey this down a little bit. And back here is dark, but not as dark. Kind of softens as it comes back there. There's a riverbank over here. Need to suggest where that's going to be. And then where this goes back, I need to make sure that waterway is visible, so I need to remind myself where that's going to be. goes off there. I've done that too high, so back there, that's all part of the bank. That's better. Okay, I'm going to come and work into this area now. I need just to play with this greenery. So I'm using ultramarine and burnt sienna to start off with. Oh, a fence there, so I need to come around that. There's a shrub that comes around there, comes across quite a long way. This comes up at least to the height of the top of the roof. Block in this wall. A little bit of a wall there. Just see a little bit of that in the water. Now, something I noticed, this has an angle on it and this doesn't here, so I need to properly play with the water in a little bit, but this is just blocking. That's better shape. I have this dark little shadow on there. And then a lighter bit on top. Similar colour to these bricks here, so I'm just going to use what's on my brush. Now, there is some shrubbery that comes in behind the house, so I'm using this green, quite bright green, and I'm using some of this grey, toning grey, just to soften it down and the tiniest touch of yellow ochre. Some of this colour on a shrub that comes in here, sort of soft green, gets brighter down there, which I'll add to in a minute, but this is just all about that layering. So this bit, I'm adding some yellow and a touch of white in there. This is just an area where there's a couple of little shrubs that are just that bit brighter. About building my layering through all of this. And there's a duller coloured bit there, still green, but I'm adding quite a lot of yellow ochre to it. This was an autumn sort of scenario. Okay, down here we've got some more greeny bits. I'm going to add some green to the burnt sienna, and that gives me, again, it's just dulling things down as we go back here. I'm going to add some of that toning grey to it as well to lighten it. This is actually more of the tree coming in from the other side, so I'll do that in a minute. Okay, so now we need some dark over here, so I'm adding some ultramarine into my sienna, give me some dark in amongst this shrub. Alright, so now I need very dark. My dinner is ready. just before this settles down, I'm just going to add a bit more white just along that water's edge. Again, just trying to keep trying to lift in it up, and it shouldn't be any higher than that. So I need to build on my trees down here. Okay, just looking and thinking, there's a tree that comes up through there, so I'm going to take my darker colour, sort of comes out the back here. Just in the background here, we've got this so I'm putting it in the same sort of colour as the leaves. I need to a little darker There is a really big tree here, a really big tree here, and then another big tree that curls up there. And in the scheme of things, these are quite important because they are here. They kind of show this place. So coming out of here, I need to have a tree that comes all the way up through there. That come across to about there. Splits up here. This one comes up this way and splits about again. There's kind of another one in here. At the back, in fact, there's several back here. Changes it, doesn't it? Don't like that. Just keep coming out through there. I'm going to put a green canopy onto that. And then we have to put this one in, and then that one. It's kind of called an autumnal green, because we are... This was referenced... I think it was November time. So I'm just dry brushing this around. So I've done the main branches, main trunks, then I'm going to put some leaves in, like I'm doing, and then I'm going to put lots more branching, then I'll put more greenery in. It's kind of a bit of this and a bit of that. So back to my small round brush to add in a bit more branch. So I'm doing burnt sienna, grey and raw umber. twisted a lot of these little branches. This prominent tree, there is a big tree that comes right up through all of this. Well, it splits about here. One more prominent tree. See if that one's going to have as close. close enough to the water's edge to have some reflections, and this one certainly has some reflections. Now this one comes up, where am I going to put it? It's one will definitely have any earrings.